My first memory of Cassidy is when I was moving my desk a week after I got back, and she came in and was like, "You're the ones that stole my desk?" Oh yeah, good first impression. We met in June, we started dating in November. I'd always kind of thought I could probably ask her out, but oh, she's a coworker, so. But then it was last October when I'm just like, I probably should. I mean, she's cute, but just, she's a coworker, and then she, yeah, kind of set up asking her out, so.
Tell us that story.
Oh, okay. So Cass is cunning, very cunning. And she knew that if she got me going on a debate, that I would keep going, and she used that to her advantage. So, she gets me talking about Man of Steel, which is one of the best movies ever made. And, of course, we're arguing, because, you know, Kathy just doesn't get how that's just the best movie, but can't marry perfect people, so. But anyway, so we're discussing whether or not how good Man of Steel is. I'm like, well, if you could see, you know, my commentary, then it would be fun. But of course, she's like, well, let's do that then. And I'm like, oh wait, she tricked me. She has tricked me into watching a movie with her one on one.
That's a date.
Very smart. She's a great friend. I would totally say that. Okay, I am the better driver, of course. She's just so cautious. It takes real skill to know master. Probably her. I get too excited. She knew I was going to ask her to marry me. So, see, I blow surprise. Yeah, she's definitely better at that. I offer to cook. She doesn't let me. I'm like, hey, can I help? Like, no, if we don't cook that much. But yeah, probably her. Probably. It's her fault, though. First kiss. So, we are definitely a movie-watching couple. And so on our second date, which she just, you know, went ahead and set up.
Wait, she set up the second date and the first date.
Well, no. She let me set up the first date. Okay. She let me set up the first date, but she went ahead and set up the second date. So, yeah. And so we're watching Inception because she was basically trying to seduce me with Christopher Nolan-themed movies. And, but I had pretty much decided by then, it's like, I want to date her, I want to kiss her. And so, but I didn't kiss anyone yet. She's my first kiss, so all sweet, all. And so we're just, you know, cuddling, watching the movie, and I'm just like, I don't even remember what I said. What did I say? And I don't even remember. So long story short, I'm just like, hey, I'll kiss you. And she's like, okay. That's the Cliff Notes version of what happened. Oh yeah. Oh, controlling the weather. 100%. Okay, see, that's a tricky question. I don't really want a superpower. I want a Star Destroyer. See, I would gladly trade any superpower for the Star Destroyer. If I had to pick, I don't know. I'd still rather have a Star Destroyer, so. No time will be better. She does not like to be called woman, which I have only done once, and it was only really because she had mentioned it that very night, and so it was just stuck in my mind, and that was a bad idea. I didn't even do it on purpose, it just came out. And she doesn't like people saying fewer when they mean less, and vice versa. She doesn't like driving people. I don't like people who drive either. They should just be off the road. But yeah, I don't know, incompetent drivers. I always like it, she always says incompetent. I don't like it when people are stupid. I don't like that at all. Especially with arguments. I don't like stupid arguments. Like, you can make a good point. That's the important part. You don't have to agree with everyone, but just make a good point. I can show you the world. Hooked on a feeling. Totally our song. Tell me, princess, now when did you last let your heart descend? I'm trying to think of them all. Take you one. Can't really pick because we just have a lot of fun all the time. Can Disneyland count as a date? I really love Disneyland. That was like, but all of them, it was there.
I can count as a date?
I'm counting that. I really like that. I can think of other dates. We usually just are around each other all the time, and so having a favorite date is like picking just a random day. We're always around each other, so. Probably her phone, a good pillow. She likes pillows. I'm really stretching here. My books. That's a lot of items. One book in particular, Democracy in America by Alexis de Tocqueville. Don't let that on my side. I have a signed one by the guy who translated it. I would not want to miss that.
That's very cool.
I like my books and my movies. She likes scaring me. She likes startling me.
What does she call you?
No. I'm not saying this. I'm not saying, you can't make me say it, Audrey. She calls me a bunny.
Wait, what was that?
A bunny. Because I startle easily. Like, a memory she loves telling people is when we were sitting in the car one time and we were just talking and she's being really sweet. And the entire time that she's being sweet, like distracting me, she's slowly turning up the volume to the car and cues up the really like the chanting part of Hooked on a Feeling, which always scares me if it just comes out of the blue. And then she turned it on, and well, she can probably tell that story better. It's not the true story, but she'll enjoy telling the rest of the story. Rome. Rome, Italy. If we had a lot of money, that's where we would go for a honeymoon. Hey, baby, I think I wanna marry you. I don't know, probably just the parents. I was just trying to make a good impression. Emily's so scary. Yeah, I don't know, probably. We sat at the same time, so. Because we, the whole time, like, we were like, when do we sit? Because we started off so quickly. Like, we said, I love you within 5 days of dating. So. Yeah, we basically sat at the same time. Oh. she has always said how smart I am. She likes how smart I am. She tries to say that I'm smarter than her. It's not true. It's not. She likes my hair. She won't let me cut it. But yeah, she's always going on about how smart I am, which I really do appreciate. She's just a fiery girl, and I love that. Like, she's so smart, and she's so, like, confident. I really love that about her. Oh, it just happened. It just happened. And, like, it was like a month after we started dating. It was after Disneyland, it was probably a couple weeks after Disneyland. And I just kind of woke up one day. I was thinking about it, I was like, I want to marry her. So yeah.
Fair enough.
All right.
All right, you pass.
Yay.